Oh, hi, it's Opie and Anthony. We're hanging out with Elmo this afternoon, watching a little TV.
Hey, Elmo?
Elmo?
Yes?
Are you having fun?
Don't do that to Elmo no more.
What'd you say? Anyways, we're teaching Elmo some new, like, words this afternoon, like stinkfist.
Stinkfist. Stinkfist. I learned a new word. Elmo learned stinkfist.
Hey, Elmo, you want to play with me and Anthony today?
Where are we going to play?
We thought we'd start with Chernobyl.
Oh, that's a fun game for Elmo. How do you play?
Follow us. We'll show you, okay?
Okay. Oh, we're playing Chernobyl.
All right, we're going to go play Chernobyl with Elmo.
Hey, Elmo, you want to play Chernobyl?
Yeah, do you want to play Chernobyl?
No, I don't want to play no more. It looked very scary.
Oh, it's not going to be scary. It's going to be fun. We're going to have lots of fun today.
No, I'm afraid of the closed-in places.
Don't...
Don't let me in there, no.
Don't worry about it.
I don't want to go. And
get him in there.
Come on, Elmo.
Get him in there. Get him in there. Get him in there.
Keep Elmo out. It's very scary in here.
You got him in there? You got him in? All right.
Don't get Elmo out of here. I don't want to get in here.
No, it's okay, Elmo. We'll just, like, put it in for, like, 10 minutes will be fun.
Not as much too long. I know. Oh, oh, my God. Oh, my God. I'm learning. Help me. Oh, no.
Oh!
That was fun, Elmo, right? Look, he had fun.
Get him out of here.
Oh, Elmo, wasn't that fun?
There was no fun at all.
You'll be okay.
I'm okay, son, man.
No, you got a tan, brother man. All right, Elmo, it's time for a new game. This one's really easy. We're going to play Drive-By Elmo.
Oh, that sounds like fun. What's that?
All you have to do is sit right over here and wave to all your friends that drive by, okay?
Sit right there and just wave?
That's all it is.
That's all it is?
Come on down here.
I like this game. I can do this.
You just sit there, Elmo. There you go.
Oh, this is going to be fun. Oh, here come some of my friends. Hi, Marie. Hi, Gordon. Hello. Oh, look, there's my school bus. Hello. Oh, who's this coming? Hi. Oh, don't go. Gordon 50187 on Sesame Street. Someone bust a cap in Elmo's ass. Oh, that hurt. Oh.
Now, Elmo, wasn't that drive-by fun?
No, that hurt, Elmo.
Well, we got one more game to play with you this afternoon.
No more games, no more games. No,
it's a ride, it's a ride. Everything will be okay.
Yeah, it's just like Disneyland, Elmo.
No, Elmo, I love Disneyland.
Yeah.
Okay, a ride is fun, a ride will be fun.
All right, follow Anthony.
Okay, come on.
Dude, there's people watching us there.
Yeah, hey, put that away. That's disgusting. Oh, my God.
Wait, that guy's throwing up in that chick on his mom's couch.
That guy is toasting English muffins with no clothes on. Look at that.
Ah.
Oh, that's putrid.
Hey, Real Rock TV, what's happening, man? It's Opie. We're up here skiing in Maine, having a great time. We had one hell of a party last night. Check out the empties, man. Hey, I got a question for you. Have you been wondering if, I don't know, Anthony's gay? You have, huh? Let's go find out, shall we? Come with me, man. Hey, cook my omelet. We're gonna take you into Anthony's bedroom.
You asshole. Well, we're here for another show, Robin. Another day in my miserable life. The whole day started off bad for me, Robin. First, my tennis court needs $5,000 in repairs. Two of my maids didn't show up for work this morning. And to top it off, there was no sparkling water in the limousine. Steven Spielberg doesn't have to put up with this. Why me? The king of everything. Why should I have to put up with this? It's an outrage, Robin. An outrage. We have an exciting show today, Robin. A full palette, if you will. Well, from let's give it the lineup. From 6 to 7, I'll be talking about me. From 7 till 8, we'll have an hour of annoying commercials. From 8 till 9, I'll be a little tired of talking about me. Why don't all you people talk about me for a while? And from 9 till 10, we'll take some calls from people who want to talk about me. We'll be back right after these words. Well, we're back, Robin, and look at the time. I've gone 3 minutes without talking about myself. My upcoming film, Pubic Hair, which will be in theaters shortly, I filmed a scene today, Robin, where I was potty trained. It's an important issue that no one wants to deal with in any of these other motion pictures. But I, Howard, the king of everything, I deal with these issues, Robin. But will I get the respect that I'm due? No, of course not. Because I'm like a scourge of society for some reason. Me, I invented film, Robin. These are the pressing issues that no one wants to deal with except me, the king of everything. I'm disgusted. I've had it, Robin. Whoa, the smell of this one, Robin. I think I left something in my pants. My God, the whole studio stinks. Unbelievable, this digestive system of mine. I think I feel another one coming. This is great. Now, I'll show you some fantastic radio, Robin. Check this out. Let me get the mic down here, because now this is radio. Boo, boo,
boo. And you never know who's going to stop by the WAAF studios. Let's hear it for Billy Idol.
Billy Idol's in the room, man. Come on, man.
It's him.
You rule,
right,
bro.
There. It's Billy Idol.
Now, I talked to Billy Idol a couple of years ago, and he remembers me because I took care of him, right?
That's right.
What do you mean, took care of him?
I didn't take care of him, dude. All right? We got a couple hot, horny girls on the phone to moan for Billy, man. And he remembers me for that, so that's got to go.
Nice.
Well, we got to thank Billy for stopping
so
by.
So there's no moaning. What happens?
Well, you want to get something going on the phone, bro?
Yeah, okay.
All right,
yeah, it's a bit more, give them a bit of moaning going on.
Yeah. All right,
moaning, yeah.
All right, if you're a hot sounding chick, Billy Idol wants you to moan today. So give us a call right now at 931-1AF. We'll play some Nirvana in the meantime. You like Nirvana?
Yes.
Okay, we'll do that. Look, they're right there for you, man. Hold on a sec. AF.
Hey. So you're looking for a moaner?
Yeah. Now listen, you're live on the radio.
Okay.
All right, Billy's here.
Okay.
Please don't curse.
Don't what?
Don't curse.
Okay.
All right. Billy is listening to you.
Yes, hello.
Billy.
Yes, hello, darling. What's your name?
Look at Billy's pants.
What's your name?
Lisa,
okay. Do you have a speaker nearby?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like to lay that speaker on the floor?
The speaker on the floor?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
We're going to have virtual sex with Billy.
You're going to have virtual sex with Billy Idol.
Oh, really?
What are you wearing?
Give good whoop.
I never believe a girl.
What am I wearing?
Yeah.
Just a t-shirt and
panties?
Underneath, yes.
Okay. Now, sit, right over the woofer?
Yeah.
Serious?
I am totally serious.
Okay.
Tell us when you're sitting right over the woofer.
Okay.
Now, is the stereo turned up nice and loud?
Yeah.
It is. Okay. Now.
Now here we go.
I can hear it. Okay.
You can hear it?
Yeah. Now Billy's gonna moan and make wild noises into the microphone, and you should hear it below.
Got to make noises that'll shake the woofer so it excites her.
Here comes Billy.
Okay.
Mind the teeth. Yes.
You need to get some deep vibrations going,
Look,
Billy.
I'm giving more than you. Come on.
All right. Do you feel like coming through your woofer?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You appreciate that, or?
Yeah, thanks a lot, lads. Great.
Feels great for Billy.
Yeah. All right, we got to get you out of here because you got a show to do, man. All right, we'll look for the project.
Break up the rest of
the break the studio. All right, we got to thank Billy Idol for stopping by the WAAF studios.
Yeah.
Thank you, WAAF, you crazy wild men out there! And women!
Radio Free Europe needs your help. This Saturday night at midnight, 107.3 WAAF takes you inside. It's WAAF's Real Rock TV.
It's Opie, it's Anthony, and it's Forrest from Braintree, Penis Boy.
Mr. Johnson, right
Mr.
here.
Mr. Johnson.
What's going to happen is Velcro is going to slide through the weights. Oh. All right?
The weights.
Right. And then it's going to loop onto itself.
Right.
Okay. And then we have another hoop that's created by the Velcro. Right.
A little noose-like thing.
Like a noose. And the noose is going to go right down the penis.
Oh, no way!
He's going to lock it in.
It's going to be locked in. We're going to start off with 5 pounds. We're going to skip the three. We're just going to go straight to five.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Yeah!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Left
here we go. Dedicate one to the lady.
Ready to go?
Yeah, let's do it, man.
All right, here he goes. He's the girl's.
Oh my god!
And
let's get the timer.
Ready?
Oh my god!
So the party was, they hadn't seen it either.
Oh,
I asked them to check the medicine cabinet, because for some reason they can leave it there sometimes, but not this time. So I told them if it pops up to let me know. I called a few people who were at the party, but they were not happy that I was starting to get desperate.
We have
I really don't like being without my penis for too long. It makes me feel like this is a man. I really hate having to sit down every time I take a
leak.
After a few hours of searching the house and calling everyone I could think of, I was starting to get very depressed, so I went to the kitchen and ate breakfast. Then as I walked down 2nd Avenue towards St. Mark's Place, where all those people sell used books and other junk on the street, I saw my penis lying in a blanket next to a broken toaster oven. Some guy was selling it. I had to buy it off him. He wanted $22, but I talked him down to $17. I took it home, washed it off, and put it back on. I was happy again.
On three, one!
People sometimes tell me I should get it permanently attached, but I don't know. Even though sometimes it's a pain in the ass, I like having a detachable penis.
He's not going to go for the 20 pounds.
On three, one, two.
Oh, wow.
And how sick was that?
Too sick. It was too disturbing to even watch.
That was unbelievable.
Wait a minute! Put that away!
It's penis cam.
It's penis cam! Dude, hold the camera straight, man. We're trying to
hold the camera with his Johnson.
That's amazing, dude. Wow!
That was a fantastic
competition that they had, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was the first annual Opie and Anthony weightlifting competition using the Spazoos.
You won't see that on Wide World of Sport.
No, dude, put that away. Put that away.
Oh.
Ah, God. It's WAAF Real Rock TV. Dude, go away. Go away. Go away. Yeah.
Yeah, that'll wait.
And then the girl goes, "But I never even had any kidneys." You right? Oh, you okay?
Oh, wait a minute. Hey, I know what that means. He wants to play charade.
Okay,
come on. Two words. First
sounds
word.
Like.
Gag. Hang.
Hang.
See,
I grab.
Wait.
Clown blew over the cuckoo's
smoke.
Nest.
Smoke.
No.
He's
choking.
What?
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
I'm in the high leg.
Stay calm. Stay calm.
Uh-oh.
My God. Wow.
You all right, dude?
You all right?
Yeah, thanks.
Hey, it's Anthony from Opie and Anthony. For Thanksgiving, we went down to American Athletic Club. What did we do, Op? Tell him.
Oh, hey, come on.
We did some kind of turkey bowling thing. Right?
Yeah, it was turkey bowling.
Cheap thrill here, too. Just kidding. Oh, hi. We're outside the American Athletic Club getting ready to do some turkey bowling. I'm here with Anthony and Lauren.
Hi.
Hi, instead of doing turkey bowling, could we possibly use those maybe to bowl?
I think you can handle it.
Hi, I'm Rocco. Greeting dinner. Stop, I'm sorry, excuse me.
Boy.
If you're watching, Opie, don't do it, dude.
Don't even start with the peas.
Do it, dude.
Come on.
If you're watching,
hey, let the guy work.
If you're watching this show, then you didn't go to Stone Temple Pilot. So here's some local H. Eat it up. Ah.
Opie and Anthony, Bayside Expo, World of Wheels here on Real Rock Television. You came out of turn two a little tight. You gotta get widen it up. You're gonna go into the wall, for God's sakes.
This is better than the Batmobile, man.
You like this? Look at him. He thinks he's Tom Cruise, Days of Thunder.
Actually, this is the WAAF race car, man.
Yeah.
How cool is this? Otto, the WAAF rock bus driver, actually drives this damn thing, man.
Isn't that hysterical that the guy that they get to drive the AAF rock bus is actually a race car driver? How stupid is that move?
Hey, I say we check out some cars. We're at the World of Wheels. Let's go check out some rides, man.
Okay, okay, okay.
And check out this ride, man.
It is beautiful. My God, look at this. Look at those double pumpers, man.
Look at the rear end job on this baby.
Nice tie rods, huh? Look at that. Look at that.
You know what I like? I like the blower. The blower's unbelievable.
Headers. What about the headers?
Oh, yeah. And the pistons. And look at that crankshaft. Oh,
beautiful crankshaft. I bet that you get some action with that thing.
Ian, get your mind out of the gutter. We're talking about the car here. You idiot.
Look at her.
Racing away.
Fun with Opie and Anthony. This is what we do when we're not on the radio, by the way.
Real Rock TV on the road. Isn't this great?
It's up for the pole!
Stop it, don't be an idiot.
Honestly.
Hey, on the Real Rock TV show tonight, we got a live performance from Power Man 5000. That's Rob Zombie's brother on lead vocals. Hey, you want to see us break a law for Real Rock TV? Get the red light on the TV.
Uh-oh, watched. Oh, my God.
Whee! We got downset. We got downset from the Middle East.
Right.
And we got a Star Wars party. And Rocco, I think, is doing something with the Monster Truck Show, man.
Yeah.
All right. Is that a cop? check out the show. We got to go.
You're screwed.
Hi, may I take your order, please?
Hi, this is going to sound really weird, but I need just a piece of cheese. One slice of American cheese, please. You see, my mom gave me a ham sandwich this morning, and I told her I always need cheese on my ham sandwich, so I need one slice of American cheese. And I don't need fries with that.
Just come around to the second window.
Well, how much does a piece of cheese cost?
I have no way of charging you for it.
Well. Yeah, I'll pay for it. What, a quarter?
Come around to the second window, please.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, thank you very much.
It's your cheese.
Cool. Piece of cheese!
Give me half.
It's, no!
It's free. Come
no!
On.
You got enough of that government cheese at home, man.
Mmm. Cheesy!
Well, here comes Mr. Funny Man. Nice joke there, O. Blowing that light. Good job. There's another installment of Real Rock TV. Hope you enjoyed it. Here comes our favorite felon, Opie. What happened, dude? Did you get the full body cavity search? Hey, bend over. How was it?
Dude, thanks for the bail money, but now how are we going to get home? They got our car.
They impounded the vehicle. I guess we hitch. Hey, see you next Saturday, man.
Ooh. I got something. We're going to put our jobs on the line. That's all I'm going to say. We got something planned. That's
Wait.
All. That's all. That's all I can say. I got to go.
All right, Opie's out of here.
Don't film this, man. We're stealing the new Aerosmith stuff, man.
All I got to do is push down the knob and we're in.
There you go. Into the boss's office.
All right.
Did you find it?
Let's go.
You got
Let's go
it.
Play it.
And we could get in trouble for this, but here you have it, guys. Put up or shut up. New Aerosmith.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to play it on Real Rock TV.
Uh-oh. We could get screwed for this.
We got the volume cranked, too. Check it out. All right, enough of that. There you have it, the new Aerosmith. We put up, all right. Now we're going to shut up, right? Right? What do you think of the new Aerosmith? Make sure you're listening to Hillman. Tuesday morning, he's going to play the whole damn song for you, all right? Thanks for watching Real Rock TV.
Hey, it's WAAF's Opie and Anthony. Welcome to another WAAF Real Rock TV show. You might be wondering what Anthony's doing in the box. Well, he's practicing to be a mime. How's it going in there, Ant?
Pretty good. They say in 2 weeks I can lose the box.
Right on. Well, you keep practicing, all right? We got a great show tonight. We got a couple live performances that you're going to love. We got Dishwala, also Tree from the WAF studios. Plus, Ozone has a really cool interview with the Black Crowes. And we go behind the scenes at Comics Come Home. It's all on WAF Real Rocks TV. What?
I can't breathe.
Don't worry. Keep practicing, man. Let's check out the show, huh? Well, there you have it, another WAF Real Rock TV show. Ant, what do you think of the show this week? Ant! If you got a comment about the WAAF Real Rock TV show, you could get to us on the web, www.waf.com. And on next week's show, we got an interview with Korn and a live performance from Cake and much more. But, Ian, put the camera down. He can't breathe. Oh, hi, man. It's Opie and Anthony, and we're getting ready for the WAAF Polar Plunge. This is a pool filled with green beer, man.
I checked it with a rectal thermometer. It's exactly 38 degrees.
Wow. I'm lightheaded. I wonder if you drink green beer, if you piss green. I always wonder that. I'm sorry. Stick around. I guess a couple is going to get married and jump into the green beer, so you're watching Real Rock TV.
Well, here they come, Robin, a couple of schlep DJs from Boston. Who's this? Opie and Anthony from WAAF come to beg at the feet of the master. Come to shower me with praise, obviously, on my movie.
Look at the size of his nose.
How you doing, Howard? What's up? Congratulations on the movie?
Congratulations? None necessary. I knew this was going to be big. I knew it was going to be huge. No congratulations necessary. On the number one movie, top box office draw, I'm bigger than Burt Reynolds in 76, and that's after Smokey and the Bandit. Ooh, I'm huge. I don't need congratulations from a couple of schleps like you. Ooh, Robin, congratulations. Ooh.
Now, Howard, some of your fans are starting to say that you have sold out. I mean, you've been on every TV show, every magazine.
Sell out.
Are you a sellout?
Sell out. Sell, now it's selling out. Only a couple of schlep jocks, as yourselves would say, sell out. I'm not selling out. I'm compromising my standards for money. Now, if you want to call that a sellout, do what you want. That's not a sellout, if you ask me, Robin.
Man, is that a bird's nest in his hair?
Howard, what about all the hype about this movie? There's a lot of hype, and your picture is everywhere. Do you think you're overexposed now?
Hype? Overexposure? Well, I'm not overexposed. I'm promoting a movie like any other normal Hollywood star would. Wait a minute. Excuse me. Hello? Yeah. Now, what do you mean I can't get on Mount Rushmore? That's preposterous. Well, work on it. Squeeze me in between Lincoln and the other guy. Preposterous. I can't get on Mount Rushmore.
Howard, you got something in your hair.
Wait a minute.
How the hell did that get there? I'm going to fire my hairstylist.
Now, Howard, don't you think you're taking this nice image a little too far? I mean, you're booked on Mr. Rogers. Dude, what's up?
Well, what I'm doing is I'm booking myself on shows where people normally wouldn't see me as me, but a couple of schleps like you obviously don't know that. Mr. Rogers, I'm getting a new audience is what I'm doing, and I am wholesome. I am a nice guy. Look at the cans on her. Hey, honey, I'd like to stick it to you. But I'm a nice guy. I'm a wholesome family man.
Now, Howard, some people see your radio show suffering because all you do all day is drone on and on about your movie. This, the movie, that, the movie, just the movie, movie, movie. You don't talk about anything else.
Look at these two schleps. My radio show suffering because all I talk about is the movie. I don't just talk about the movie. I talk about a lot of different things on my radio show. Different things every day, not just the movie. Excuse me. Hello, why are you bothering me? Yeah. Oh, the people are here for the how many times have you seen Howard's movie contest? We'll send them right in for the next segment. A lot of different things, not just the movie.
Now, Howard, this is just an observation, but it seems to me that you're starting to become everything that you were against. Mm. Howard, are you going Hollywood?
I'm not affected by the Hollywood lifestyle. That's another preposterous, bizarre statement from you two jiggleheads. I don't know what the hell you are. I'm a regular guy. For instance, my private jet, the carpeting doesn't even have padding under it. Do you know what that could do to your feet, going back and forth to the bathroom after five bottles of Moe? It hurts.
Now, Howard, with all the hype you had for this movie, with the premiere and the Hollywood stars and everything, how do you explain that after 1 week, only 1 week, your movie attendance dropped by 40%?
40% down? No, first of all, it was 39.8%. Shows what you know about movies. A couple of boneheads from Boston. First of all, there was massive flooding in the Midwest. Do you realize that? Are people going to canoe to the movie theater, Mr. Smartass? And the Hale-Bopp comet was out. There's a comet streaking across the sky. You can't expect people won't want to see the comet. That's why some of my movie proceeds took a slight dip. You disgust me. Get out of here. Yeah, send in the guy that eats my snot. I'll show you what real radio is. You disgust me. Preposterous, Robin. Down to 40%. Got a commercial.
Ah, we're at the polar plunge. Another guy just took the plunge. Get a shot of this guy's willy. I bet you it's about 2 inches long right now. Look at it! Look at it! That green beer is so freaking cold. Every guy is going from
McCormick.
To there. They obviously, he's drank much too much today. Here, fling that hat up here. He's an accountant. This is the most exciting thing he's done in his whole life. Oh, jeez. That's gotta hurt. He gets a 9 for style. Yeah, we haven't gotten any girls yet, but yeah, Derek is getting up in his Rage Against the Machine shirt. Obviously, a tough guy. Oh, nice blast radius. That was good. I like that one.
Here we go. Up next, number 7, Teresa Johnson.
Girl. Yeah!
You will, bro.
He's in the water. We had to call 911. Obviously, hypo.
We want to party with this guy. He's doing it right, man. Yeah, he got laid before. See what's around his neck? Oh. He made that face. He made that face like you do after you do a shot of tequila. Oh, he's rubbing his hands together like that's going to help. Like that's going to warm him up. See that? Look at the pain. Look at the pain in his face. Whoa. Get a shot of the girl. Uh-oh. Don't comment about it. She'll kick your ass. Come on. Down. Oh, come on. And he never... Where's the top? Whoa. Oh, right away. Very nice. Very nice style. He can't even get up the ladder. And the jump?
Okay.
He didn't get that wacky hat. If you're wearing a hat like that on St. Patty's Day, believe me, the police will probably be pulling you over later in the night. They're coming out like they just walked away from a plane crash. I'm freezing standing on top of the rock bus. I cannot imagine even getting near the pool. Forget about it. And he's in. Another girl. She's taking her gold watch off. Oh, don't give it to Bruce. Don't give it to Bruce. Now she could drink and swim in beer. And he's in. A little painful. He's not coming up. Oh, there he is. I thought he was dead. And he's in. Another one takes the plunge. And he's dead. I would never do this. I don't know how they get people to do this.
There's
green shorts. That. Oh, he's hurting. He's hurting. Look at him. He's all confused. Well, that pretty much wraps up the outside portion of the polar plunge. We had our people jump into the freezing cold green beer. I think they're doing a triage inside to see who needs medical attention more urgently than the next guy. That was stupid fun on Real Rock TV, man. That was awesome. Stick around. We're going to be giving away $1,000 to one of those lucky morons that just jumped into the green beer.
WAAF's Real Rock TV. We'll be right back.
Dudes, it's Real Rock TV. It's Opie. It's Anthony. Broadcasting live outside the Fleet Center for the Metallica show. We got a pair of tickets to Metallica that we're going to give away to this guy, possibly.
Yeah.
What's your name, man?
Chris.
Chris, and your friend?
Nick.
Hey. All right, he's a little shy to be on TV. This is the deal, man. Chris is going to strip down to his underwear. I don't want to see it, but I'm sure you do, okay? And he's going to run across the street to Christie's. It's open 24 hours. And in his underwear, you're going to buy ribbed condoms.
Trojans.
He does that for Real Rock TV. We're going to hand him a pair of tickets to see Metallica. Simple as that,
what
right?
What a twisted moron.
We're going to do that in a few minutes. Stay there.
Rock 107.3 WAAF. It's Opie and Anthony broadcasting live outside the Fleet Center.
That's right. And we got a treat today, don't we?
Yeah, we got a little excitement for everyone. We're filming a piece for Real Rock TV because we got a pair of tickets for Metallica. And we got our boys, Chris and Nick, in their underwear right now. Now, Chris, what are you going to be doing for us for these tickets?
I'm going to be running down to the convenience store down there and getting a, getting some condoms.
In his underwear, man.
In my underwear.
And what are you going to get, Nick?
I'm going to get a Playgirl.
So he's going to get a Playgirl. He's going to get the condoms. They're both in his underwear. We're filming this for Real Rock TV. I say we go right now because we've got a huge crowd outside.
Take him across with the camera and Opie. I'll wait here back at home base.
All right, Anthony is going to wait here in the Rock Bus. I'm going to call the
Rock Bus.
You
know what happened.
Open that door, boys, and let's go.
And
is he going?
Open the door.
Go! Go!
Anything gay?
Anything?
What do you think of these guys?
I think they're f***ing dynamite, man.
Thank you very much. He bought a...
some gay man.
Do we get the condoms, man?
Yeah.
We got condoms. Let's go. Let's go.
Guys.
They did it, and they got Metallica tickets.
Were they getting some wacky looks over there, huh?
Big time. There was this big black lady that was enjoying the scene big time. She had to be about 60 years old.
And what about the girl that said they were cute and grabbed one of the guys?
I think she's coming over here to hang with us.
Really?
So. Yeah, man.
Well, I guess she liked the package.
All right, that's very cool, and we just taped that for Real Rock TV. We'll have that in a future episode.
We're here for Veruca and Saul. Nina and Louise. You know, I didn't know much about you guys, so I got a bio. And you guys make it really hard, man.
I know, we do.
And you know about your bio and the Mad Libs and stuff?
Yeah, of course we know. We've read about it.
Veruca Salt's Mad Woman's Lib. All right. We've all played Mad Lib when we were young. All right. Veruca Salt are back with their second skunk, 8 arms to hold you. Here's a smelly bio of the band. Louise Post and Nina Gordon met on New Pickle Eve 1992. Through a mutual movie star, they quickly realized they were musical dorks and decided to form a bathroom. 8 months later, they met bassist Steve Lack through a waxy ad they placed in a local Chicago dumpster. Soon after, Nina's bumpy brother Jim agreed to play drums and Veruca Salt were ready to drink. They made a 4-song demo and were signed to Chicago's indie Minty Fresh Hot Dogs after only 3 live lizards. Thank you, guys. That sums it up.
Come on. You know what you're getting.
Look, at least you get a little laugh. If not a lot of confusion, just a little laugh.
Live lizards.
Instead of like, Nina and Louise met.
Right. This dynamic.
The band, they're so earnest and they really need to be They write their own lyrics in their bedrooms. They come together and they sing them together. They sing them.
Were you guys those girls in high school that nobody would approach because you were like the artsy-fartsy girls?
They were like... Party girls. Popular party girls.
That's what we'd like to hear.
Oh, man, how do you work this freaking thing? Hey, it's Opie, and we got Anthony working the camera today. Anthony, hold the camera still, will you?
Okay.
All right, listen, a lot of people email and write me and Ant, and they say, what do you guys do on a Saturday night at midnight? Well, tell you the truth, they don't really pay us a lot here at AAF, so what we have to do to make extra money is actually start the Real Rock TV show every Saturday night. Now, what button do I push here?
Hit the play button.
Play button.
Hit the play button.
There's a panic button. Play.
Hit the button.
Dude, the commercials just ended.
What?
The commercials just ended.
I'm at the station. I'm supposed to be running Real Rock TV tonight. Come on. All right, what's the next segment, dude? What's the next segment?
Sponge.
Sponge at Axis?
Yeah.
All right, check it out on Real Rock TV.
Relax. It's Beth. WAAF's Real Rock TV.
Hey, it's Anthony from the Opie and Anthony Show. Welcome to Real Rock TV. If you thought what we did to Elmo was bad, wait till you see what we got in store for Snack Time Cabbage Patch. This thing...
Whoa!
I told you to keep it away from your hair!
And oh my God.
Take it away. Am I?
Oh.
Ow. Ow.
Stick around.
Ow.
For Dennis Leary. I, Mother Earth. Get it? Hold still. I can't shut it off. The Nixons and Local H. Real Rock TV. Hold still. Go hold still. It's coming, I think.
For the love of God, get this off my head. It's getting close to my scalp.
Hey, you enjoying the show? I wouldn't know. I can't watch it because Opie didn't listen and put the damn thing by his hair. Hold still.
Scott does something really weird. He plays the bass guitar.
Has a bass pickup.
Oh, bass pickup, okay.
In his guitar.
And vocals.
Yeah, he goes into a bass amp and a guitar amp.
Oh my goodness.
But for acoustic shows, I play bass and Gabe Road Dog plays drums.
Man, that is
I saw him nodding off over there, though. What was that? Guy had his eyes shut. It's a good time to take a nap while you're playing.
One of the songs I like off the new CD is a song called Eddie Vedder.
Vedder.
You got to explain it, first of all.
Well,
why the fixation with Eddie Vedder? Why the fixation with Eddie Vedder?
Because he's so...
He's so popular. He's popular.
Well, that cleared that up.
Yeah. Right.
No, we like Eddie Vedder, and it's not a knock towards Eddie Vedder or Pearl Jam. It's about liking Eddie Vedder.
All right. Yeah. Do you think you'd get more chicks if you were Eddie Vedder? Or
yes.
Yes, we probably would.
That's exactly the point.
That's our problem.
I know. That's the point of the song.
We're chickless.
I think I'd get more chicks if I was Eddie Vedder.
And that's what I got from the song when I heard it, man. You guys want to play that one?
We are chickless.
Okay. Yes. It's Eddie Vedder. It's Local H off As Good As Dead.
We're chickless.
We're chickles.
Chickless. No.
Hold still. I couldn't find the battery pack. It's coming loose. It wasn't that a cool Real Rock TV show?
Hell with the TV show. Get this damn doll off my head.
I got enough room. Scissors. Scissors.
Ow.
Hold on. Hold on. It's close. It's real close. Ah, there it is.
Let me see. Don't worry, it'll grow back.
What do you mean? Give me a mirror.
It looks fine. It looks fine.
Did you see that, Robert? Another blatant example of how they're ripping me off. I'm an innovator. No one's ever original anymore. That was obviously a blatant ripoff of me, the king of everything. I'm disgusted. Okay, we're back, and... I have some more. I'm being ripped off again, Robin. Have you heard this WAAF Real Rock TV? They're filming inside the radio station with video cameras. Who thought of that, Robin? Me, Howard. I invented the video camera. And now they got this Real Rock TV where they're going to be showing behind the scenes of radio station. It's an outrageous ripoff, Robin. Well, we're out of time again. Wow, where did the time go, Robin? I gotta get the plugs in, catch Jerky the Jackman at the Bayonne Comedy Toilet, and our interview with Stammering Jim tomorrow, where he actually kicks Mother Teresa. It's hysterical. I'd like to thank all of my guests today, and Robin, I want to thank you, and most of all, I want to thank me. And we'll see you next time. Are we done? Hey, Robin, that Real Rock TV, the tape I saw, it's really not that bad. It's a pretty good show, actually. I think I got some ideas from that.
Well, it's Opie and Anthony broadcasting live.
We got three buildings between us and ABU, actually. We need some television sets. And some brassieres.
That's right. We are collecting bras for our next stunt that you are not going to believe. So if you're coming down to the live broadcast in front of IHOP on Soldiers Field Road in Brighton, bring your bras and bring your TVs, because I think we're going to tune in our TVs to Channel 68 and smash them today, man.
We'll throw some bricks through them.
Exactly. So come on down. We'll see you in a little bit. All right? Cool.
107.3 WAAF, the only station that really rocks. It's Opie and Anthony broadcasting live in front of the IHOP on Soldiers Field Road in Brighton, 1850. We are literally three buildings away from the station that banned our TV show.
Might have to pull out a driver, see if we can get a golf club over there.
TV! Yeah!
disgusting. Ludicrous. I can't even watch anymore. I'm disgusted. Now, this is what they had a problem with. I'm looking at Beth Hart. She's not wearing a bra, but she has no boobs. You can't even see. I have seen more nipple from Pamela Anderson on Baywatch than what Beth Hart is showing right now.
I'm stuck. Okay, so are you taking these?
I'm taking these. Thank you very much.
All right, we have lots going on. First of all, everyone say hi, because no one believes we're here. Everyone's coming by to say hi. They're bringing their bras. They're bringing their TVs. And we just showed a portion of the band TV show.
Yeah.
Now, according to WAVU, they had a problem with Beth Hart, one of the performers here on AF, because she was performing for our TV show without a bra. Now, I mean, we've been talking on our you-know-what for the last 3-4 days.
Yeah.
But now we have a lot of our listeners that have checked it out for the first time.
I thought, you know, it's cold in the studio. You see Charles Adler, he's got bigger nipples than she does. You know? Pretty much, it gets cold in the studio. He could cut glass with those things, you know. She did nothing.
Hey, what's your name, man?
Jason.
And I hope you have a TV at home besides that one.
Oh, yeah.
Good. You're not to watch Channel 68, though, right?
Absolutely not.
That's nothing to watch. Oh, yeah.
He doesn't want to watch Mama's Family or Little House on the Prairie or religious programming at night. He wants to see AF, Real Rock TV.
Here's the console.
It's the flight cap I actually wore when we bombed AB-68 over there. ABU. It works good. Not much padding for a crash landing, but it's kind of cool to touch. Cop a feel.
The audio is changing happening here.
Here is typical programming from T68.
WABU! No.
It's the golden old bags.
Who wants to see that?
I want to see that.
This show sucks.
Yeah.
The station sucks.
We've just been informed back at the station by a TV repairman that when this thing blows up, it's going to be like a small bomb. So Anthony's talking to the people.
Okay, this could be dangerous.
I don't believe it. I'm going right in. Head first.
This guy went below. You can put your boot right through that
door. Let's get a little pump going on.
Here he goes again.
All right. WAF Studios. You guys want to see why we get paid so much money here at AAF? Watch, I'm going to do my job.
The best station.
AAF rules!
The
mighty, mighty rock station.
Your station really rocks.
All right. I just made money. All right, cool. It's time for another Real Rock TV show. Tonight on the show, and why do you have a bra on your head, man? All right, tonight on the show, we got Power Man 5000 from the Indoor Beach Party, also another society from the Middle East, and we stop into the Ozone Cafe for an acoustic performance from the Hazies. Will you stop distracting me? Hey, Anthony, Opie and Anthony show, Real Rock TV. Michael Jackson has exclusive pictures of him and his new baby in the Inquirer, but they edited the shot. Here's how it really looked.
I love you, baby. You're my child.
Oh,
stick around for the hazies on the Ozone Cafe.
How old are you? 16. All right, that's old enough. All right, you guys, you ready to rock or what? Huh? Let's hear it for my pals, Another Society.
Well, there it is, another fine episode of Real Rock TV, showing a little bit of the beach party, and future episodes of Real Rock TV will have even more of the beach party if you weren't there. And if you were, you might see yourself. What?
We got a Bryan Adams CD in here.
Another Bryan Adams CD showed up in our catalog? In the WAAF CD collection? That's Bryan Adams, all right. Reckless. And it's good! 3 points! See you next week.
Hey, it's Opie and Anthony backstage at the indoor beach party with the Hazies. Introduce yourself.
I'm Wes.
Hi, Wes. Who are you? I say we all just molest the sheep for 5 minutes. That'll make a good interview, right? What do you guys think out there? Was that rocking or what?
It was incredible. It was fun. It was vibing.
It was fantastic.
Fantastic.
I loved it. I loved it.
Hey, loved it. Dude, can I try on your glasses?
Sure, man.
All
right.
You don't want to try my jacket?
Wait a minute.
But I got to try some.
How about the jacket?
No, I want the hat.
The whole thing, man. Let me hold this.
Yeah, while they're changing, we'll go back to the studio with Bertha. Over here we got Bertha. Backstage, see, this is what really goes on behind the scenes. See, what's your name, ma'am?
Deb.
And are you having a good time today?
I'm having a great time. I'm watching guys change. This is great.
Who was your favorite band today?
Hazies. Hazies.
All right, correct answer. We're going to go back now to the studio. Oh, he's like Mr. Pee Pee. It's Mr. Pee Pee. He's happy to be here today. He's a big fan of the Hazies and the sheep, too. Oh, God. He's going to penetrate the sheep.
Hey, it's Opie and Anthony. We're kind of hanging out at the Boston Blazers lacrosse practice with Jeff.
Deep inside. How you doing?
Deep inside the Hindenburg, by the way. We're in a dirigible floating high above Boston. Now, Jeff just got off the field, and he's, like, really sweaty and stuff, but he's been nice enough to join us on Real Rock TV. Now, I know one misconception about indoor lacrosse.
Okay.
You guys don't make $1 million a year.
No, we don't even make a tenth of that.
I heard rumors that you guys make about $100 to $200 a game.
Average player makes about $2.25. Highest paid player is only about $550.
He's getting like 60 minutes with you probing at him like this, Ope. You're scaring me. No, I know this because I had a few buddies from high school that played indoor lacrosse, and they did it just for the love of the game, man.
Yeah, that's the only thing that we can do. It's like the NHL started with the original six. I guess we're the original six.
The pioneers of indoor lacrosse. Say hi to Mark, man, from the Boston Blazers.
Hey, how's it going?
Know what I noticed about you, dude? You got some like gnarly scabs on your knee, man. Check it out. You got to get on Real Rock TV. Yeah! Awesome. Awesome. These pads really do work.
Something.
Now, dude, when you're not playing lacrosse, what do you do for a living?
I'm actually a stripper part-time. No, I'm just kidding.
We've decided to find the worst scar on the team.
My God, what is going on over there?
Well, you know, it's part of the game. You take your lumps once in a while, and you just strap it back on 6 months later.
I got to ask, how did that happen, man?
A guy came around, gave me a two-hander to the back of the bone, which gave me a spiral fracture, and we went from there.
Do you think anyone on the team could beat that scar? Figured I'd
Rodney
ask.
Rodney Tapper's whole head.
Really? Hey, it's Opie and Anthony. You know, Ant, a lot of confusion is happening over our WOW concept.
Confusion, controversy, everything.
So we figured we'd set the record straight and show you what WOW is all about.
It's easy. In terms I think everyone can understand.
Exactly. We got a little demonstration plan for you guys.
Very scientific.
And we got our bosses supervising this to make sure we don't go over the line in our demonstration. Okay? Okay. All right, the concept for Whip 'Em Out Wednesday is real easy. Here we have Mr. Joe Schmo coming home from a hard day's work.
He sees a couple of nice girls, willing participants of WOW. They have a WOW on their own car.
He looks over. They look back.
Let's see what happens.
Ah.
He's a lucky man. Look at the smile on his face. He just got wowed, and he'll be smiling for weeks, Anthony.
He's going to go home a happy man.
Now that was a good sighting, and there he goes home to his lovely bride.
A happier Anthony. Man. A happier man.
Much happier man. Now here's what the cops think happens after a wow sighting. Check this out. Tragic.
Certainly is, Opie. Don't let this happen to you, fellow wowers. Be careful out there on the highways.
Hey, Real Rock TV, it's Opie and Anthony. We're in the middle of Whip 'em Out Wednesday, man. I barely have time to open up the show. I got to talk to some people here. AF!
Hey, listen, I just had a sighting. I just got off the Mass Pike.
Where was the sighting?
This was, right near 13 in Framingham on the Pike.
Let me get that.
Okay.
Yeah, Anthony's going to the Whip 'em Out Wednesday map. I'll start the show here on Real Rock TV this week. We got Tracy Bonham, Collective
Sun,
and Dinosaur Jr. All right, Ed. AF.
Son, can I speak to Opie and Anthony?
We're right here. What's up, buddy?
Son, you guys rock, man. I'm driving up 126.
Yeah.
In Boone, man.
Yeah!
I'm telling you, I couldn't believe it.
Anthony, 126, Anthony.
Marking it.
Got it!
Oh, man, you guys are the best in the air,
this is Nicole.
What's up, Nicole?
Nothing. I have a problem with this Whip It Out Wednesday thing.
How could you possibly have a problem with Whip 'em Out Wednesday?
Yes.
Tracy Bonham on Real Rock TV. We got to talk to this girl, so check out Tracy from Ozone's Cafe.
We got to talk her in. It's okay. Everything will be fine with your little boob.
Relax. It's back. WAAF's Real Rock TV.
Oh, my God, we're getting too many sightings. It's taking a lot out of our power here at the war room. I don't think we can handle another boob sighting on Whip 'em Out Wednesday, I'm telling you. Uh-oh, emergency! Well, I hope you enjoyed Real Rock TV. I hope there's enough power to end the show here at...
I'm Rocco. I'm messing with Ian. Hey, we're at the Framingham Post Office. It's tax night. Turn around, Ian. Look at all the cars back there. All these people freaking out trying to get their taxes in by midnight tonight. They need to be postmarked or you're going to pay a penalty. Are you paying a penalty, Opie?
What, are you kidding me? I got the extra size envelope. I'm paying so much freaking money.
How much money?
A lot.
What's it look like?
I can't afford it.
Tell me what you want to tell the IRS right now.
Actually, you open the show because I got to get ready for the tax man, okay?
All right, get ready. Opie's getting ready for the tax man. There it is. Come on in. Coming up on this show, we got Korn. We got Helmet, and we're going to go to the Rat and check out Drain, four Swedish chicks that rock.
We had to cut into the music because our girlfriends are here.
Yeah.
Nina and Louise from Veruca Salt.
Remember that last time?
Yeah, you mean last time where you said
forget.
The F word 20 times on our show? Do you realize you cost us $500?
Did we really?
That's okay.
No, we never
we talked
pay
our way out of it.
Yeah, we never pay him anyway. We got a little surprise for you. Do you like this?
Oh my God.
That's Jean Noir?
Jean Noir Le Blanc?
Jean Noir Le Blanc? Johnny Walker Black, of course.
That's our drink of choice.
That's our drink of choice.
We remembered from last interview.
See?
See how nice we are to you girls?
I have to say, because this is the only station that really rocks, I partied with Slash once. And he was very impressed with my choice of scotch, Johnny Walker Black. We kind of bonded on...
Really?
Yeah, which was pretty... I mean, that was a pretty exciting moment to bond with Slash about alcohol. It just seemed like I had arrived, you know?
Something tells me if you were drinking Sterno, he'd probably be like, that's my favorite drink!
You guys were on Rosie O'Donnell.
Rosie O'Grady.
Me and Anthony were talking about that on the radio yesterday, actually.
You
I saw
you.
Because Anthony actually saw it. I didn't see it yet.
Yeah, I saw it, and I have to say, I was in bed, naked.
On the show, the Rosie O'Grady show, underneath my clothes, I was naked too.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Right on.
We have bonded.
Well, that is cool.
I think, you know, housewives need to rock too.
Yeah. I think they like seeing girls up there rocking too. You know, it's not like if you had a guy band up there,
exactly.
And they would be petrified.
Did Rosie try to feed you guys ringdings after your performance?
We didn't get the ringdings.
No?
You know, I'm originally from the East Coast where, you know, you can only get Drake's cakes on the East Coast
because
they only have Hostess in the Midwest and on the West Coast.
Ooh.
And so I would, it's true.
I know.
And I would love a Devil Dog, and I totally forgot to ask for strikes. Louise likes black. Grilled cheese and scotch at 3 in the morning.
She hangs
out with her cats and drinks scotch and eats grilled cheese by candlelight. Thank you.
And you got a little Metallica connection. People should know about that.
Absolutely. Right. What's our Metallica connection, Steve?
We've slept with them. What is our Metallica?
Bob Rock, duh.
Not just Bob Rock. We're also managed by the same people.
Yeah, it's obvious. The influence is awesome.
We played a show with them in the North Pole.
Mm-hmm. Yo, you did?
Yeah. In Tuktoyaktuk.
Oh, right.
The Molson.
That thing.
Yeah. And we're highly influenced by them on stage. You'll see tonight. We learned a lot of our arena rock moves from Metallica.
Arena rock.
I like your video where you're bouncing around on the rubber bands.
Rubber bands? I like to think of them as nooses.
Nooses.
Swinging on nooses.
Well, you bounce. It's like some kind of bungee thing.
Yes, bungee.
Exactly.
Yeah, was that fun or was it a pain in the ass?
Both.
It was a pain in the armpits.
Pain in the crotch.
Was it?
Mm-hmm.
Do you like doing videos?
Yeah.
You like doing videos?
I love them.
I detect some sarcasm.
A little bit of sarcasm.
A little bit.
Tell us why. You can be honest on this show.
I'll tell you. There's like stupid directors that don't see your vision, man.
Yeah, my vision, exactly.
I want the girls going up and down on the rubber bands.
Basically, we just have directors who forget to get Steve in the shot a lot of the time.
Oh, and that's why he's pissed off.
Yeah, Howard. How is that? Now you got obviously
get the short end of the stick.
Yeah,
especially when there are two bumping females in the band.
Behind every good woman, there is a good man. And
there's a dumb man.
There's a really dumb man who does as he's told.
There's a sucker.
There's a big dork.
At least your video doesn't have anything rotting in it. I'm so glad we're starting to get away from the rotting flesh in videos.
Yeah,
little insects, the underbelly of our...
Yeah, and then the blurry, like, quick cuts and...
There are a couple of those, and I was kind of bummed when I saw them. Yeah, and in our new video, there are a couple of those, and it's such a trendy thing, but it's always that way. Like, for a while, it was white flashes in videos. Yeah. All the videos had to have. And it's just the way people... Because something new happens in technology, like there's a camera that you can use that you can actually go in and out of focus like that, and then everybody wants to use it.
Yeah, because now you see it on, like, a Tampax commercial.
Yeah, exactly.
Doing the quick cuts and the bright flashing light and the overexposed.
I think Marilyn Manson was actually asked to do an endorsement of Playtex tampons.
Really?
Yeah. But wasn't there a time in the early 90s when there were chalkboards in every video?
Yes.
That's a good one, too.
And little scribbly writing.
Yeah,
because
we're talking about all the stuff in all the 90s videos. You have to have the old man. You have to have the rotting corpse of something.
Right, the old man sweeping the floor.
Yeah, the overexposed.
In slow motion.
In slow motion,
you
right.
have to have a little kid. We did that.
Right, someone with no expression on their face.
Right, little, right.
They got to just look like directly into the camera and then a quick cut to them smiling. Yeah. Something silly. I could do
something
a video.
Really profound.
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? When you guys did Sound of the Bell on our show last time you were in, and your voice did that little squeaky thing,
I
have a tape of that I just play at home when I'm alone.
Can you just sample it when you're naked? The best part about coming on your show last time was the call from that guy.
Oh my
god! I've just been sitting around drinking, and those girls rock. No, but he said like three cuss words in a row.
Yeah,
which I won't say right now.
And you topped them right after that with four.
Which started a new policy on the Opie and Anthony show. We have to be on delay now.
Do you think drink a lot in general? You think your listeners as much as we do?
I think people in general drink a lot. Who are you kidding?
I thought for a while it was just the people I hung out with, but I think it is everybody.
So Anthony, you and that guy who called have a little bit of things in common.
Like what?
Lying around naked, listening to Veruca Salt.
And drinking. Yeah, that's what I do. I lay there naked, scratch myself, and pop in Veruca Salt. This is great.
I think we should let them get ready for the big show today.
Yeah, the gig.
We could talk to you guys forever.
Oh, that's
this
sweet.
Is like
we
fun.
Could talk to you guys forever.
Cool.
Are you gonna watch us tonight?
Yeah.
That's good.
When you sleep.
Do you have your?
Can you like dedicate a song to me and Anthony
Which
tonight?
One?
Sound of the Bell.
We're not playing it.
We don't even know that.
Play it. Not right now. We only have 45 minutes.
Oh, that's right.
We got to get in all the hits.
You got to get
either
play them twice as fast, and you can play twice the song.
We were doing that for a while.
Do you play straight?
Yeah. Yeah. We'll dedicate that to you.
Yeah, straight's cool.
My voice is just as cached as the last time I spoke with you, so you'll hear me cracking all night.
All right. Well, we got to think.
Really grossing me out.
And grossing Steve out is quite an achievement.
Really?
Yeah.
Hey, it's Opie and Anthony. We are at Salisbury Beach State Reservation for the beach dig. Look, they're still digging.
They're digging over there.
All right, back to us. Screw them.
It's summer. It's warm. It's nice. Look at all the people. Check it out. We're at the beach.
And, you know, a lot of people haven't been to the beach in a very long time. So today on the program, we're going to have some summer beach tips for you guys. Also on Real Rock TV tonight, we got Blessed Event, our pals.
Oh, those guys are twisted.
Also, Motley Crue from, where do they play, Orpheum?
Orpheum,
right? And lots of other stuff. So sit back. It's another episode of Real Rock TV. Hey, it's Opie and Anthony. We're doing summertime tips today.
Yeah, this is fun. It's the beginning of the summer, and we figure guys need a little help on how to pick up on the girls on the beach. Tips from Opie and Anthony.
Exactly. You want to pick up a girl at the beach, all you need is a ball.
A ball.
One ball.
And a chick.
And a chick. We need a chick.
Dude.
Right over here. Okay. All right, check this out. You take the ball.
Okay.
And all of a sudden you go, oops. Oh. Oh, I'm sorry.
Ball?
Yeah, you want to play?
Absolutely. What you playing?
I'm playing ball. All right, Anthony, see?
That was smooth.
That was smooth, right? Okay. I started a conversation with the girl.
I think now, I
you
got
tried.
It. Just the ball.
You tried. Okay.
Okay. Oh, you asshole!
How was that, man?
Dude, she called you an asshole.
That wasn't good?
I don't think so.
We'll be back with some more tips in a little bit. I thought it was good.
Pudding.
Are we going to show Chuck Farnham covered with pudding?
Yes.
In San Francisco,
yes.
Wherever the hell he was?
Now, a lot of people have heard Chuck Farnham on our show. He's our wacko friend from the left coast. And a lot of people call us up and go, oh, and what does Chuck Farnham look like? Well, we found a clip of our pal Chuck Farnham. Check it out.
Mayor, close the beaches. Brody, this was not a boating accident. Hey, Chief, I hope you brought your rubbers. Here's the swimming with bow-legged women.
A lot of people have been calling me an aunt, and they want to know if when we duct-taped our intern to the pole, if that was real. We finally had the footage. Check it out.
Hooper, keep your eye on her, Hooper. She's going under the boat.
All right, more beach tips from Opie and Anthony. I established a conversation with this fine young lady, right? Now you got to be concerned with her needs, all right? We're talking, we're hanging, we're catching some rays. All of a sudden, I notice that she's got a little bug on her shoulder. Oh, sweetie, you got a little mosquito there. Let me take care of that.
Oh, thank you. That was so sweet.
Anthony, give it a try.
I'm going to give this Opie tip a try. Physical contact. Hey, I noticed you got a little bug on you there.
Could you get it for me?
Sure.
Ah!
Ow. Hey, that didn't work.
All right, it's time for another beach tip. You're hanging. We've been having a great time. We've been here now a couple hours. You really got to take care of your lady at the beach, okay? For example, sweetie, you're getting a little red on your knees.
Oh, I am. Could you help me?
Oh, I could easily do that for you.
Thank you.
Huh? We're getting there. Anthony, you want to try it?
Sure. Hey, looks like you're getting a little red sitting out in the sun. You need a little lotion?
Maybe a little bit.
Okay.
Oh! You loser!
Happening?
I'm a loser. I'm striking out like crazy. What do I do?
You got one more shot. Go for the sweet talk. Girls love sweet talk.
Talk about her looks?
Yeah. Just go over there and whatever you notice about her, talk about it. Nice and sweet, though.
Okay. Hi. Jesus, look at the on you. I was noticing your ass earlier. It's a nice ass. I like to to that. Come on, but we could make beautiful music together. You know what I mean?
It's obvious who scored at the beach. Ant, here.
Is it something I said? What did I do?
Standing here, looking at you.
When?
Oh, you
Wait a minute. Opie, you're a f***ing maniac. Oh, my God, Opie. You cracked her in the head. You son of a bitch.
Da, da, da.
Live Shutterbug in their underwear. Did you see them? Did you see?
Yeah, that was Baruch Gasol from Webster Theater in Hartford. And here's the interview with our girlfriends. We couldn't be there, but check it out.
Hey, boy. Gonna show you some of the Jiffy Lube 300 from Loudon. Where the hell is Loudon?
It's in the boonies somewhere.
Watch some good old boys go around the track. It's a lot of fun.
Hey, you still watching the show in there? Good. All right. Hey, this is one of my favorite bands that we're playing on AAF these days. It's Days of the New. We had a live performance with those guys at Newbury Comics in Shrewsbury. Check it out.
Hey, thanks for watching Real Rock TV. Me and Anthony are out of here, man. See ya.
Die!
Oh, what the?
Was that Dave Douglas, our boss?
You killed the boss.
He's still moving. He's all right.
Call an ambulance.
Check out Cowboy Mouth, man. Jenny says.
Where's his wallet?
Oh, hi. It's Opie. I'm just getting ready for my great radio show. This is what I do to get ready for the show. I just kind of hang out here and think. You're watching Real Rock TV, and me and Anthony have this new concept called Testicle Tuesday. Testicle Tuesday, a chance for you to show us your balls. We want you to come up with outrageous stunts, and then we put it on the radio and put it on Real Rock TV. If you got an idea, you got to get a hold of me through email or give us a call, okay? But anyway, Steve and Kim came up with a stunt we like to call the waterbed burst. Check it out on Real Rock TV. If you look to your left, you'll see the firing squads that they have set up against the cement barriers. They're actually shooting people that have come in to see the show.
That must have been a serious offense, like open container.
And we're so deep in the Great Woods parking lot system here that we're actually shooting at deer in the woods. So.
Yeah.
I actually brought my high-powered rifle, and I got enough venison to last me all winter.
Right.
I see someone getting frisked.
Oh, yeah, man.
I think, oh, my God, he's in possession of charcoal briquettes.
a felony here in the parking lot at Great Woods.
All right. You guys having a good time out there tonight?
Yeah!
It's Opie and Anthony live from Great Woods for the Rage Against the Machine show. Now, what's going on in the parking lot this afternoon?
Well, we showed up, and, you know, we're just going to party for a little while. Kid next to us drinking one beer, and the cops found it. Search his car for 10 minutes. And they give him the choice, get arrested or go home. They ripped up his ticket. All the kids in his car got their tickets ripped up. I mean,
wow, they ripped the tickets up?
I think the cops are provoking more trouble just by, you know, searching all the cars. Yeah, you're making the kids want to rebel and it causes trouble. I mean, people are just here to see the band. You know,
just a little fun, right?
Well, yeah, a little fun involved.
Just a little.
How you doing? Welcome to another episode of Real Rock TV. For those of you new in town, because it's school.
Do you have any change?
We didn't
put any.
That's Opie.
We didn't put any money in the meters. We're gonna get a ticket.
I have no change. I got my keys.
Uh-oh.
Excuse me, you have any change?
Ah! Ah!
See, Boston's a really cool city, and, like, there's a lot of colleges here, and there's a lot of bars to check out, but you gotta make sure you do some of your schoolwork. That's an actual person that failed all the freaking finals. You don't want to be like that, do you? Anthony, intro the show.
Tonight, we have Helmet, we have Screaming Cheetah Wheelies, and we have the Mighty Mighty Boss Tones. And we also have Tickle Me Elmo. He's gonna get chewed up in the wood chipper. We did that for Christmas, but we're bringing it back because it was so much fun.
Hey, we got to tell everyone where we are. It's Opie and Anthony from AAF, and we're next to the Ejaculating Fountain, a very famous spot here in Boston, all right? While you check out the Ejaculating Fountain,
the water gets me every time.
Where are you going? All right, Anthony's got to take a look. Don't worry about him. We did some wild, wild stuff with the Elmo, Tickle Me Elmo doll from last year, and to get a picture of him taking a leak. Alright, yeah, we messed with the Tickle Me Elmo doll. In case you missed it from last year, you gotta check this out on Real Rock TV.
Ah, the Crew Building. Very famous here in Boston for you newbies here. You're away from home for the first time, huh? Away from mommy and daddy? Plenty of things to do in Boston. Got clubs up the Yim Yam, Middle East, Paradise. What else we got?
Axis, Mamakin. Tons of places to see shows. You'll be there. You'll get there, I'm sure. We had a real cool band at our indoor beach park. Helmet. You know the song Like I Care? Check it out live on Real Rock TV.
What are you looking at? What are you, getting a tinge of salvation looking at this church? You're watching Real Rock TV.
I don't know.
Furthest thing from this.
I don't know, Ant. Maybe we still have a chance.
Nah. Hey, check out Screaming Cheetah Wheelies. They're going to do Magnolia, I believe. Blues-oriented rock band, wouldn't you say, Opie?
Yes, I would.
It's got that voice.
This was filmed as part of the End of Summer Cruise with the Hillman. Check it out.
Oh! Hi. Welcome back.
Anthony.
Yeah?
What's that building?
I don't know. That's like one building I'm not too sure of in town. I've never even been there. It's, I believe they house books there.
Books?
Books. It's like videos, but only the pictures don't move or something.
Dude, this is a back-to-school special. You don't need to know about that building. You're in Boston. It's a party town. Screw that. Don't waste your time in that building. Please. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Real Rock TV. We're on every Saturday night at midnight on WUNI. And, that building just scared me.
It is scary.
Here's another song from the Mighty Mighty Boston. Thanks for checking us out, all right?
Good night.
You think we could download porn in that building?
I think there's actually pictures in the books, and if they're old paintings, they're probably naked.
Hey guys, we're at Omni Multimedia, and we got a surprise for you guys. This is pretty cool. They're messing up our CD, and our good friend Dick is going to show us around the place. He's a friend of the show and friend of the station. Come on in.
Ah, executive office.
Dick, what's up?
Hey, Opie. Anthony, what's up?
How you doing?
Hey, dude, it's a cameraman, not really.
You guys kind of have, we got big jobs in here, we can't let you be filming this shit, you know what I mean? I'll show you the whole place, but,
I can't bring it in, you just want me to bring it in.
Oh, you got that, like, little side camera that you sneak in your little side pocket there?
Yeah, I can do that. You guys up for that?
Yeah, I feel like Mike Wallace, 60 Minutes, let's do it.
All right.
Sorry about that, guys. I hope you don't mind.
You know, no, that's cool. Hey, rules are rules.
We dream
of security
policy.
We really don't like our freaking rules.
All right, guys. All right, come on, let's go.
When he comes in, this is where we prepare the CDs for a pressing operation.
You got a funky jam on that damn thing right
we
now.
We do music for everybody.
I feel like Hank Phillippe Ryan.
Hey, guys, cool. You're not getting lost, are you?
Nah.
Stay up with us, right? Make a master in the other building. You make a stamp for every job has a different master.
Science!
See right now your own CD being printed.
Actually, I think our CD how they package them.
Guys, this is our graphics department. This is where we do all our work to prepare for the printing department. Patty, this is Opie and Anthony.
Hi,
Patty.
Hi,
how are you doing? Patty's working on your job right here.
What's that?
Dude, we almost had that in there.
That's the floor, I guess. That's the coach.
This is our packaging machine. This is where we put all the CDs together. Final packaging, and this is how we're going to ship it out to the record stores for you guys. Right here.
WAAF's Real Rock TV. We'll be right back.
Hey, welcome to Real Rock TV. Follow me, I'll tell you what's on. I gotta go get Anthony real fast. Get out of my way! Anthony!
What?
We gotta open the show for Real Rock TV.
I'm doing my art! For Christ's sake!
Real Rock TV 46, Everclear, from the Ozone Cafe. They were right in there, performing live. Demented World CD signing. Where the hell's the CD? For God's... Available at a record store near you. Cool for August! Don't want to be here. At a Loca Bazooka. Rocco's Kiddio? What is that? What's Rocco's Kiddio? Sammy Hagar performs at Hampton Beach Casino. That's cool. We've had Sammy on the show before. And, Opie sucks a... I'm working. I'm very busy. Production.
Oh, this is going to be cool. Mike Brangiafori's on the air right now. He's trying to pick up a chick. Come on in here.
Mike, say hi to Real Rock TV.
Hi, Real Rock TV.
What's your name?
I'm afraid I can't tell you right now.
All right.
I'll send you the money later.
Last time Mike was on Real Rock TV, he hit Spider in the head with the microphone, and he hasn't been on Real Rock since, I do believe, right?
I've been banished. They're finally letting me back on.
Good to see you again. Intro this song. Cool for August, I think. Hey, this is Cool for August. What song is it? Don't Want to Be Here? Trials? Don't Want to Be Here.
Hope you enjoyed Real Rock TV.
got something special for you. Anthony's sister is up from New York, and she swears she doesn't have a New York accent. Let's check it out, all right?
And then Opie took the squash and jammed it right up there with his...
Oh, hi, Opie!
See, some of the spots you hear on WAAF, I record the voice. I do everything. I put the music. Opie, on the other hand, is screwed up so badly here at WAAF doing commercials, they give him stuff like this. At a store near you.
Yeah. Make some magic happen.
We're gonna try anyway. Who's on the rock bus right now?
Me.
And who's me?
Me, myself, and I.
Is this?
Hi, this is Dave.
Yeah,
we made it happen.
How are you?
Damn,
dude, I am like shaking. I mean, I've interviewed.
Wait, where are you? Who am I talking?
All right,
we are from Venus. Take us to your leader.
Yeah, I am from Uranus.
This is Opie and Anthony from WAAF Radio.
Hi, how are you? You're not in this van, are you?
Actually, we're in the back room.
Are you? Can I go check?
All right, go check.
Okay, don't
go
pay check. No attention to the man behind the door.
Liar! There's nothing back here.
Well, we're like...
Hey, hold on a second. There's a bunch of M&Ms in a box. Hear that?
Okay.
You're getting warmer, Doc. Warmer.
Okay, there's a Halloween thingy. Yes. Oh my God! There's beer back here.
Well, yeah. You can have all that beer.
Hey, someone
Mr.
already
Grohl.
Presented me with my complimentary bottle of tequila.
Well, can I explain what's going on here for you? We figured
someone's got some explaining.
Okay,
to do.
We figured me and Anthony, you know, figured that you've been on the road a very long time now. Okay, you've been doing a lot of. You were on Letterman last night, for Christ's sake. You guys look good, by the way.
Thank you, sir.
And we figured, you know, Dave Grohl doesn't want to look at me and Anthony. We're like, you know, boring to look at. So we sent the lovely Heather.
Heather.
Thank you, Heather, very much for coming.
Is she hot? She is so cute.
Yeah, she's pretty cute.
Yeah. Oh, look at you, as a matter of fact. Mr. Dave Grohl, he just tours around seeing beautiful women all the time.
I know. You know what? I just...
Getting jaded.
I am. It just gets to the point where I just don't give a brat's ass.
Dude, this is kind of surreal, because last night I passed out on the couch with my girlfriend.
Yeah?
And I was trying to stay up to watch you guys on Letterman.
Yeah.
And I woke up when you guys started jamming. I was like, yeah, cool, they're finally on. And you guys looked great on Letterman last night, and now here we are talking to you.
You got, like, really bad stage fright when you do things like that?
Maybe. Why?
Well, I read that.
Come on, man, don't freak me out. I got to play tonight.
No, I'm not. Like live TV or something freaks you out, and you're, like, almost
you know,
get sick.
Live TV isn't as bad as getting up in front of, like, 3,000 people.
Really?
Hell no!
I don't think live TV would be worse.
No! Live TV is just like a camera.
You could just cover everything in crowd noise, though, when you're in front of a bunch of people.
No, not
you
really.
You F up on camera.
Like, if you're... Well, also, when you play shows, you have to be up there for, like, an hour and 15 minutes.
Yeah, that's true.
So, that gets to be...
Well, you would know better than I.
Yeah, because who are you? You're the faceless guy sitting in front of a microphone in a studio.
Just keep looking at Heather.
Yeah, keep looking at Heather, and we'll have her move her mouth as we talk.
Okay.
How's that?
Okay, speak.
I got to thank you personally, because I was in radio hell. I was working in Buffalo,
yeah.
And I was getting really sick of all the hair bands that we had to play, you know.
And we're in Buffalo?
Yeah.
Hey, is that where buffalo wings come from?
Yeah, of course.
Anyway, what were you saying?
I was getting sick of playing all the hair bands. Everyone was sounding alike, and then this lovely little band from Seattle, you know, blew us all away, and I just want to thank you for that, because it, you know, it really helped out my career.
I like Soundgarden too; they were great.
All right. Well, obviously, you know, the grunge thing is going away.
Yeah.
And I want to ask you, Dave Grohl.
Yes, sir.
Where do you think music is going now?
I mean, I listen to everything. I listen to everything from Radiohead to The Prodigy to Puff Daddy to, you know, I listen to almost any kind of music.
Zamfir, Master of the Pan Flute?
What's that?
Zamfir, Master of the Pan Flute?
No, man, he sucks. Zamfir blows.
Hey, now, Dave, when the listeners found out that you were coming on AF today, the faxes and the phones are going crazy. There's only one question I want to ask about Nirvana, because, you know, I really want to talk about the Foo Fighters, but is there any other projects in the work down the road?
For what?
For Nirvana.
Oh, for Nirvana.
Yeah. Because everyone is asking us. You gotta ask Dave.
I don't even really know.
I know it's not on the top of your mind, but...
I don't know. I mean, I'm sure, of course, something else will come out someday. And there's some stuff that hasn't been released that was recorded, but there's really not much. We can't do, like, We can't do the anthology trip because we only went to the studio like twice.
Right.
So
right.
And we used everything that we recorded pretty much. So there's only a couple of songs left. And someday they'll probably come out.
Okay.
I suppose.
Wow. This has been a thrill. It doesn't get much better than this.
I agree.
I'm serious, though, dude.
I definitely agree. This has been 100%.
Well, you want that girl to get naked or what?
No, you know, you don't have to get naked.
Come on, Heather.
No.
Heather, so, come on. Heather.
She just flipped you off.
You take the control this time.
Hi.
I got it last time, and it's always a mess.
Hi, Real Rock TV. You would think with a hit CD that me and Anthony have out, Demented World, that we'd be able to quit our second job. No such luck. It's time for Real Rock TV. We got highlights from the Halloween party with Veruca Salt and 7 Mary 3 and the Honey Rods. And the highlights from the costume contest and all that. So I think we're going to start the show with, like, Veruca Salt to Volcano Girls. Come on in.
I need a new bag. It's full. Oh.
I almost got it. Oh, dude. Hi.
Hey, what's up?
I hope you're enjoying Real Rock TV. I think we got 7 Mary 3 doing covers of...
$5.
Yeah.
What?
Highest sales nationwide. Opie and Anthony, Demented World, 43 in the whole damn country.
That's national, right?
Yeah.
Not just local?
Mm-mm.
We must be like big things.
Cool.
We're popular.
Hey, we're beating out Duran Duran.
That means we really suck.
I don't know what that means.
Oh, dude, he's taping us. It's Real Rock TV. I think we're going to see the Honey Rods. The rat.
Oh.
Hold the elevator. You all right?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Hey, we got Veruca Salt. Want to see that? Look at that guy. These aren't the actual panties.
Oh.
That I stole from Louise of Veruca Salt, but they are a stunning simulation. You alright?
Yeah, I'm alright.
How's your head? Is there an alarm going off?
No, I have not shooting at me.
Idiot? And they're off! Don't these half hours just fly by on Real Rock TV? Entertaining as hell. We're going to leave you with Veruca Salt, the Seether. Seether! Okay? Now, next week on Real Rock TV, I think we might be doing something interesting. Ian Barrett, who is working the camera right now, might actually host the show next week. Woo! Is that true, Ian? All right, give me the camera so you can tell the people what you plan on doing.
Well, you know, we...
Oh, sorry.
That's all right. You don't know what you're doing. Well, next week I figured we'd gotten a lot of emails about me hosting the show because no one's
uh-huh.
asked me before. So uh-huh. I thought maybe we'd have uh-huh. some year reviews.
Uh-huh.
Some
hey, let's guests. Get out of here. Hey! Get the camera! Hey! 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 Thanks for watching Real Rock TV. We'll see you next week.